students, welcome to RecTV. This is Kalyan and I'm the faculty of mathematics and physics. So in this session also we are going to solve one different problem on trigonometric identities. I mean those three identities which are sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, secant square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1 and cosecant square theta minus cot square theta equal to 1. Based on them we are going to solve one more problem in this video. Let us see what the problem is. See here. We need to prove that sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta, this is plus, okay, plus cosecant theta is equal to 2 plus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta. So if you want to do it as it is, okay, it may be difficult. Why? Because if you want to show this equal to 2 plus something, it is looking some clumsy, no? Now better do some rearrangement, then after you prove something. Okay, for our convenience, okay, what I am going to do is do the rearrangement for this problem. Now take this sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta. Okay, the sine theta, cot theta, cosecant theta is one more expression another side of the equation. Better bring this to this side. This becomes plus, no, this becomes minus. That would be your sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta equal to what? 2. Instead of proving this equal to 2 plus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta, better we prove, okay, sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta equal to 2. It is better, no? Because it's very simple to show. Understood. So now we are not going to prove the given thing as it is. Sometimes we need to think different. I am telling you, for every problem, if you do the answer in the same method, is not possible. No. Sometimes we need to think smart. Here, if you want to prove, if you will take LHS given as it is, which is given as it is, and if you want to obtain 2 plus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta, it will be a bit clumsy. Better than that, you can observe that on LHS part and RHS part, one common terms are there, sine theta and sine theta, cot theta plus cosecant theta and cot theta minus cosecant theta, only sine is altered, remaining everything same. Better you bring them all to a side. So after bringing all them aside, sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta, when brought aside, this is somehow looking easy for solving that. And to get 2, now you consider this entire expression. Let me highlight with a different color. Here, consider this all as LHS. Once again, I am noticing that we are not considering LHS part as in the given problem as it is. We just have rearranged the terms of LHS and RHS. Now we are considering this all as LHS, and now we need to obtain what? 2 as what? RHS. So this is our task. Understood? So we, after rearranging the terms of the given equation, now we are going to take this entire part as LHS and we need to obtain this RHS, which is 2, and of course it looks very easy to get. Understand? So now take LHS part as this. Okay, we took this LHS part. Okay, I am rewriting that. Sine theta, that is LHS, sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta. Now this is LHS after rearrangement, and now we need to obtain this RHS. Let us see this here. Now here two fractions are there. Out of two fractions, here common term is sine theta, we can take it common. Now take it out. Now what is left inside the brackets? Here was when sine theta we took common, here one is left over, by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus, again here one will be left over, cot theta minus cosecant theta inside the brackets. Okay, and to solve this problem for the next step, take LCM. Taking LCM, what we have to do here? This is denominator and this is denominator. Do the cross multiplication and multiply the denominators together and put them under the denominator part. Okay, so what we have to do here? Just see sine theta into now cot theta minus cosecant theta. Cot theta minus cosecant theta. This is one. Minus of, this is minus symbol, take care, while minus symbol will be there in front of them. Okay, this is minus, minus 1 into cot theta means minus of cot theta plus cosecant theta, right, by, multiply these two together, it's a process of taking LCM. Okay, cot theta plus cosecant theta into cot theta minus cosecant theta, right? Like this, we took the LCM of, I mean, this into this, by this into this. We put it like this. Okay, now just tell me. Here, sine theta. Now, just simplify this bracket. What we have to do? Cot theta minus cosecant theta, minus into plus would be minus cot theta, minus into plus would be again minus cosecant theta. Now solve these two brackets, cot theta plus cosecant theta into cot theta minus cosecant theta, again this is in the form of what? A plus B into A minus B. As you know that this is an algebraic identity and we can get the value of this as A square minus B square. It's a standard formula. Using this we can solve the denominator part also. How can we write it? A is cot theta and B is cosecant theta. So that means here A plus B, cot theta plus cosecant theta, cot theta minus cosecant theta, then multiply together to get A square minus B square. That means cot square theta minus cosecant square theta, right? Till now, is it okay for you or not? It's a simple thing I have done. Now, as the cot theta symbols are different in numerator part, minus cot theta plus cot theta getting cancelled. Okay, now what is left over? Just see, this is sine theta outside the bracket. Now, minus cosecant theta minus cosecant theta added together to get minus 2 cosecant theta, right? Okay, now if you carefully observe, this is cot square theta minus cosecant square theta. Is it not looking like a trigonometric identity? Yes, it's a trigonometric standard identity. If you take common minus symbol out of these two terms in the denominator part, okay, what do we get? If you take common minus 1 from this denominator part, both the terms of denominator part, symbols are getting changed. So therefore, minus cosecant square theta becomes, when we took common minus out of this, cosecant square theta symbol will be converted from minus to plus minus. Cot square theta is plus actually. After taking minus common, it becomes minus cot square theta. Right? So now tell me, in numerator part and denominator part, minus is common. So, minus by minus becomes plus. Okay. This minus by minus. Minus 1 and minus 1 can be cancelled. You can think in that way. Okay. In both the denominator part and numerator part, okay, if minus is there, then it becomes plus. Because you can see, you can feel that minus and minus is cancelled. Or else minus 1 and minus 1 is cancelled over there. Right? Okay. Anyways. So, here what is left over now? Tell me. Here inside the brackets, what it is? Cosecant square theta minus cot square theta, which is a standard identity, and value of the cosecant square theta minus cot square theta would be how much? 1. So how can we write this further? Sine theta, okay, minus is already diminished, so here 2 cosecant theta into 2 cosecant theta. By this is the value of entire denominator be 1. Minuses are almost cancelled. So here minus are cancelled. This is 2 cosecant theta, which is I wrote here. And here this is sine theta, which I wrote here. Now this is cosecant square theta minus cos square theta, which is standard identity, and value of it would be 1. Right? So now tell me, sine theta into cosecant theta, can we cancel or not? Okay, if there are beginners, I'll write it in detail. This is sine theta into 2 into what? Cosecant theta. Again, cosecant theta is a reciprocal of sine theta or not? So we can write this as 1 by sine theta. Now we can cancel these two or not? Numerator and denominator sine theta parts are cancelled. Sine thetas are cancelled, and what is left over? 2. So in our modified version, what is RHS part? 2. So we obtained RHS or not? Exactly. So we obtained it. So we took LHS and we obtained RHS. So hence the problem is proved. Understood. But here we need to take care of one thing, that we shouldn't take LHS part as it is given. Okay, we shouldn't take LHS part, we shouldn't consider LHS part as it is given. We need to do some modification. After taking this term to another side, then you take this entire expression as LHS, and you need to get the value 2 as RHS. Then it can be proved what we have done here. I think you might have understood this all the problem. Okay, you can observe this step by step process, and then after, let us move on to the next problem.
Please subscribe and don't forget to click the bell icon for the more updates. Please subscribe and don't forget to click the bell icon for the more updates.